Ladies and gentlemen, our semi-main event, Brian Armitrud and Barry Michael Sports, welcome you to 10 rounds of boxing for the Australian Cruiserweight Championship. NABF supervisor Mr. Frank Hadley, bound for Tokyo, as he reminisces about the late Lionel Rose. Ladies and gentlemen, would you welcome in the red corner, the challenger from Blair Gowrie, Victoria, via Blacktown, New South Wales, head coach Lincoln Hudson, elite fight gym Penrith, decorated amateur champion, gold medal Melbourne Commonwealth Games 2006, Beijing Olympics 2008, just back from the United States of America, where he continued his record of 7 fights, 7 wins, no losses, 5 in, side the distance, at 90.70 kilograms, white trunks with a touch of black. Would you welcome the man they dubbed Hollywood, Brad Pitt? And across the ring in the blue corner, from Stockton, Newcastle, New South Wales, head coach Peter Hallett, a professional looking record of 26 fights, 21 wins, 4 losses, 1 draw, 4 inside the distance, wearing total black trunks like Mike Tyson, tonight making the 5th defence of his Australian Cruiserweight Championship. At 88.95 kilograms, ladies and gentlemen, the sizzling southpaw, reigning and defending champion, the Doberman, Daniel Amen. Referee Malcolm Bull, the judges Ignatius Mitsilaitis, Andrew Campbell, and Samantha Bulner. Here we go.
A hard act to follow.
Okay, welcome to the center ring, gentlemen. Good, clean fight. Obey my instructions at all times. And may the best man win. Shake hands now. Come on, fighting at the bell. Good luck.
Two big, tall cruiserweights. They really are for this under 90.71 kilo division. 200 pound or 14 stone 4. If that makes a little more sense to you. The big boys, big, tall boys. Both about 6'2". All national titles contested, done so over 10 three-minute rounds. All state titles, 8 three-minute rounds.
Okay, let's go.
And it's time we got it on. The Australian Cruiserweight title is the reward for the winner here. Daniel Amman v. Brad Pitt. Amman is the champion. Pitt is the challenger. Amman in the black trunks. Pitt in the white and black. Right-hander versus a left-hander. Could at times be ugly.
Certainly will, and with Daniel Amman's style, it could get even uglier, and it's going to be good to see how Brad Pitt handles Daniel Amman's style, because he's very cagey, very crafty, and sort of awkward a little for most fighters.
Great young ambassador, Brad Pitt. We had him on Fox Sports News on Wednesday night, promoting tonight's event. And was as nervous as he could possibly be in front of a camera, but presented beautifully, spoke perfectly, and did tonight and the industry a great service.
Yeah, no, he's a good guy. He's very humble and very down-to-earth sort of a guy.
Long reach.
He's probably got the best left jab out of all the heavier fighters going around. We won't see it as much tonight because it's against the southpaw, which you don't see too often. Unless you're Robbie Medley that night down at Penrith, we saw against Gary Comer the best left jab you'll see against the southpaw. Well, there it is from Pitt.
Saw him with that straight right hand. That's the go. Against the lefty, Amman just a tough boy though. This is 6th title defence already. Dominic Vay, Anthony McCracken, Brett Smith.
The Dominic Vay fight was a cracker. I think from memory it was only Vay's 3rd fight or something like that. And they went the distance. It was an absolute cracker of a fight.
Speaking of going the distance, 4 fights back, July of last year, Daniel went the 10-round distance with Shane Cameron on the Danny Green, Paul Briggs undercard in Perth. You go 10 rounds with the Mountain Warrior, you know you're doing something right.
Cameras. Oh, beautiful right hand from Pitt as they clash heads on the way in.
Followed him with a really short, snappy left hand then, Brad Pitt.
He's got a good left jab. Speaking to him earlier, said he's been doing a lot of rounds with Jamie Pittman, 50-odd rounds with Jamie Pittman, one of the better super middleweights going around here in Australia.
And just a lefty, and a big super middleweight as well.
Yeah,
part of the Grange program.
Said he had trouble finding a good left-handed fighter, but he said Pittman was perfect for this fight tonight.
Both thinking fighters. Not going to rush in and do anything silly. Nor would you when the title's on the line.
Nice short chopping right hand there from Aman, and that's what Pitt's got to get used to.
Mouth guard is out.
The breast. Okay, box.
And back on. Not a lot left in the round. Nothing. As we go to the stools, Fidel Turk and Lincoln Hudson from Elite Fight Gym in Penrith. Daniel Aman. In the other corner, what can he produce? Brad Pitt victorious over Oscar Ciali. That was in Perth. That was the same card of Daniel Aman and Shane Cameron. This was on the undercard and a very tough kiwi in Oscar Ciali, who Dominic Vade had a war with. Well, Brad Pitt took three rounds, stopped him, and dropped him.
It was only 3 weeks after the Dominic Vade fight, and that was too quick to back up, and that was Brad Pitt's best performance to date.
Brad Pitt had six fights down under, and his seventh and first overseas was in February of this year, a six-round points victory, unanimous points victory over Josh Harris in Nebraska. And in speaking to him throughout the week, he learnt so much about boxing and so much about himself. Travelling, going through a completely different routine in a very different environment.
I think he tasted the canvas in that fight for the first time in his professional career. Oh, good combination from Pitt. He's got fast hands, Brad Pitt.
2006 Commonwealth Games gold medalist is this young man in the heavyweight division. Same weight as what he's fighting at now, but the heavyweight division in the amateurs.
In the amateurs, that was the year that he really became someone in the amateurs, because it was always Adam Forsyth before that.
Yep.
They had the best battles that you would have seen in amateur boxing, these guys. You know, I guess it matched the days of Richie Rolls and Chris Hamiltons and the Daniel Gills. And it was either Pitt or Forsyth. They went back and forth, and that year, Pitt got him and got the gold.
Are we going to see Adam Forsyth, Brad Pitt as professionals down the track?
It'd be mouth-watering.
No stranger to one another, as Chris has pointed out. Halfway through round number two.
Forsyth back in action on June 3 in Perth, so it'd be good to see him get back in.
On the back foot here, Brad Pitt pops out that long left hand.
That's
and
over.
We have a new cruiserweight champion of Australia. His name is Brad Hollywood Pitt.
That is the fastest left hook you will see in Australian boxing. You wait till you see this on replay. You blink, you miss it. That was an absolute cracker. Unbelievable punch from Brad Pitt. Out of nowhere, I was just about to say, Daniel Aman just keeps peppering with that left hand to the body. Sorry, it was the right hook from Brad Pitt. Speed of plenty.
Power punching from Hollywood.
Wow.
That is now eight fights, eight wins. Six inside the distance.
Have a look at this. Boom.
And a new Australian cruiserweight champion.
Oh, flush on the temple. That's the temple shot you called, Andy. Earlier on in the night. Oh, sleep. Look at him. He just strolls away. There's grave concerns for Daniel Aman.
being tended to by Dr. Peter Lewis and the medical crew here, right on top of things, centering. Brad Pitt happy with the victory, elated with the victory, but not like this, showing some concern for one of his rivals.
Yeah, that's right. Great respect from Brad Pitt. He's not jumping around and being silly. He's, you know, showing Daniel Amand the respect he deserves.
Let's take a look at a list of former Cruiserweight champions, because Brad Hollywood Pitt is the latest to hold the belt. Daniel Amand, of course. Lawrence Tuasa. Very tough Adrian Bellin. Our man Swifty Gregley. Apollo Sweet and Kevin Wagstaff. All former Aussie Cruiserweight champion. And Brad Pitt joins that illustrious group as Daniel Amand is assisted back to the corner. Let's take another look at what was just a devastating right hand. Just rocked him.
Amazing.
And he knew straight away, Brad Pitt.
He did, and look, this is what to love about Brad Pitt. He's just won the national belt, and look at the guy. He's not jumping around with joy, he's showing respect.
Let's go centering to make it official with Howard Lee.
Thank you, Andy. Sensational knockout. 1 minute, 45 seconds into round two. Would you congratulate the new national cruiserweight champion, unbeaten Hollywood, Brad Pitt?